has been averaging 7.1 rebounds per contest. Bakersfield Jam will send out these five players. Jeremy Wise at the one. He is 14.1 points per game. Leading assist totaler, or rather second leading assist totaler in the D-League this season. 6'1", 165-pounder out of South Mississippi. He'll be met in the backcourt by Ronaldo Major, is a 6'6 swingman out of Fresno State, 15.7 points per contest. Former member of the Sioux Falls Skyforce is Major. At the three spot, it'll be Derek Byers, 18.6 points per contest, 6'7" out of Vanderbilt. And the four will be Adam Cook. He is out of Northern Iowa, 255-pounder, and he is 6'6.6 points per contest. And Jamie Vanderbeeken in center, 6'11" out of Iowa State, and he averages 6.5 points per contest. The affiliates for the Sioux Falls Skyforce are the Minnesota Timberwolves, the Miami Heat, and the Orlando Magic. And the Bakersfield Jam, they are affiliated with the Los Angeles Clippers, the Phoenix Suns, and the Toronto Raptors. On the schedule for tonight in the NBA Development League, even though it is Thursday night, since it is after the All-Star break completion, there are a quartet of games, a trio of games besides this one. The Iowa Energy and the Canton Charge are on the court tonight. Also, the Austin Toros will be at the Texas Legends, who have in their fold Lamar Odom from the Dallas Mavericks on assignment. Also, the LA Defenders will be at the Idaho Stampede tonight in Treasure Valley. Two teams head to the court. And the Bakersfield Jam have as their color motif a very dark blue. You can almost call it a midnight blue. White numerals and kind of a gold stripes down the sides of their tops and trunks, and red around the tops of the collar of the tops. While the Skyforce are in their home whites and the teal numerals and the black shading around their numerals. Keith Benson and Jamie Vanderbeeken in the jump circle. We're ready to do it up as our officials, Garrick Shannon, Greg Dandridge, and Charles Watson patrolling tonight. And the tap will be put up by Shannon and controlled by the Skyforce. So Malcolm Lee will set it up, and he'll work it right side. Try to hit Benson in the post. He gets it on the right block. Benson with a couple of moves. Double team comes. Then it fades away, and he'll whip the pass over to Lee. And they get it over to Gilder, who's down below. His shot blocked from the first attempt, but we got a whistle underneath. And a foul on Ronaldo Major of the Bakersfield Jam. So the first possession of the game, Nets free throws for Trey Gilder. And Gilder definitely has been coming on for the Sioux Falls Skyforce. He has scored the most Skyforce points over the last five games and has been the leading scorer in all of those. And he swishes the first free throw. And for his efforts, Trey Gilder has now leapt into the tops of the scoring averages. His 17.1 points per game, now 10th in the D-League. His second free throw is no good, so it's a 1-0 Skyforce lead as Bakersfield will come to the near court. I am high above the south end of the Sioux Falls Arena, and the Skyforce will play to the north end to start the ball game. Byers will give it back to Vanderbeeken, who will fire the three, and it's good. Vanderbeeken likes to shoot that outside shot, and he drills his first attempt of the night to make it 3-1. Malcolm Lee with a behind-the-back dribble will dish it off to Anthony Mason Jr. His shot is wide left, and Bakersfield will board it. And the long lead pass, Byers has to hoist it back over his head, and Trey Gilder comes up with a loose ball. Coleman, now Malcolm Lee, left side. Two-point shot. It's off the back iron, and the rebound back up and in by Trey Gilder. Gilder is the leading scorer for the Skyforce and leading rebounder, and he has been the man for the Skyforce and has put all 3 points up so far. Tie ball game, 10:38 left first quarter. To the hole comes Ronaldo Major, and he leaks his way into the hoop and lays it up with the left hand. 5-3 with 10:26 left in the first period as Lee looks left side, will shuttle pass to Gilder on the right. Gilder with a bounce, now will give it up to Coleman in the right corner. Now Coleman with a left-handed bounce, gives it up to Benson in the post. Benson turns, has the ball knocked away, and it is off of, the officials were conferring, and it'll say off of Vanderbeeken. Five to shoot. in this sequence with 10-11 left in the first quarter. Bakersfield hitting their first two shots of the ball game, and the score 5-3. Mason's going to try it in the paint. He'll lay it up and in. Snuck past Adam Cook along the left baseline off the feed. Five apiece, and here's a three put up by Derek Byers. Swish. Derek Byers burns it down from the left side. 8-5, and Bakersfield has come out smoking tonight. They have hit their first three shots. There's a pass. It's in and out of the hands of Benson. Back comes Bakersfield. Wise loses the ball. He actually slips down. They'll say he was bumped from behind by Dominique Coleman. Foul number one on the Skyforce. Bakersfield leading by a tray. 9:41 left in the first period as Major will get it in. Wise gives it up to Byers. He's open. He'll fire. Hit again. Anthony Mason Jr. late on the defense. And a six-point edge as the baskets being rained from downtown. Three of them so far for the Jam. Keith Benson's jumper from the free throw line, too strong, and the rebound picked up by Byers, and he is raked from behind by Keith Benson on the reach. Bakersfield will inbound it from the side. Well, Bakersfield with their 18-16 record on the season so far. They're looking to erase the loss that they got at the hands of Dakota last night. It's a one-loss win streak. They beat Canton before that. Steal on this end as the Skyforce rake it away. Now they'll play it, trailing 11-5 in their front court. Still to this point, Bakersfield has not missed a shot. 11-5 the score. 9 on the shot clock as Malcolm Lee will back it out. Now he'll attack. Pulls it down. Gives it up to Benson. He's down low. His shot is blocked, but they'll say contact. Vanderbeeken looking wistfully towards the basket support. And Keith Benson will go to the line to shoot a pair. For the second time tonight, the Skyforce earn charity tosses. Benson has not been very proficient in his 12 games with the Skyforce, 53%, but he's good on that one. Benson has been with the Skyforce since joining the team via the player pool on January 26th. Second one, too strong for Benson. Bakersfield the rebound, quickly front court. Byers is going to chase the way to the rim, up on off the glass and in. Danced on the rim just a bit. And Byers gets his first two of the night, and still Bakersfield has not missed. 13-6. Five in a row from the floor. Here's a three for Malcolm Lee. It's too strong. Rebound Byers. 7-point Bakersfield lead as they come front court. Here it is. It's a layup for Adam Cook as Jeremy Wise drew the defense. Streaking down the court, Adam Cook. And six straight shots for the Jam. And a timeout called by Mo McCone and the Sioux Falls Skyforce as they have been lax defensively to start the ballgame. 15-6. We'll be back in 2 minutes on the D-League Radio Network.
More volunteers back here. Yes, come on down. Yes, your hands are here. Come on down. We need some more volunteers. A few more vultures. If you're 16 and over, right back there, yes, come on down. Excellent, great.
Well, the Bakersfield Jam can't ask for any better to start the ball game. 6 of 6 from the floor, 3 of 3 from behind the arc, and 3 of 3 from inside the arc. And they lead it 15-6 with 8:07 left in the first quarter. I don't think the Austin Toros are shooting 6 of 6 from the floor, but they have jumped out to a similar 15-6 lead over the Texas Legends early on in their contest. Gilder will give it up to Lee, and the clock resumes with 8 minutes left in the first quarter. Mason has it left side, gives it up to Lee. Now to Coleman, right side, 6 to shoot as Lee will look it over. Now he'll fade to the left, attack the baseline, jump it, and it's short, hits the rim. Benson taps it back up and in.
Keith Benson
with the offensive putback, and it's 15-8. Bakersfield with Wise will fade. Now gives it up to Byers. Does he still have the stroke? We shall see. No, he'll give it up to Vanderbeek, and he will fire, and now it's the first miss. And the rebound, Coleman. Coleman will weave his way to the right and get it to the baseline where Lee has it. Can't fire it on Cook, and they'll loop it out front. Now they'll give it back to Lee. Lee to the free throw line. Coleman's open from 20. He will fire left side. Too strong. Rebound, Gilder. Gilder with a couple of moves in the paint. Can't shoot it. Gives it up to Mason. Mason, he will pull up from 20. Too strong. Rebound, Benson. And the Skyforce will continue to play it. 7:05 left, and they trail it 15-8. Lee will slow it down just a bit. As Lee has the defense leak away from him, he'll take it all the way to the jar. Missed the layup. Benson back up. Oh, and he missed that one. Too strong on the putback attempt for Benson. Now they'll get it the other way with Major into the paint on Mason. Byers is open. He'll fire the three. Too strong. And the rebound one-handed. Pulled down by Major, and they're going to call number 2 on Coleman. So Coleman will pick up the second team foul, actually third team foul on the Skyforce. And that will prompt a move from the bench. Gabe Pruitt will check on. He is a 6'4 guard out of Southern California, former NBA veteran, former NBA champion with the Boston Celtics. He will take the place of Coleman, and Bakersfield will stand pat with 6:36 left. As the clock resumes its pace, Wise gives it up to Major. Free throw line jumper. It rolls around and falls in. 17-8, 9-point Bakersfield lead. Lee with the pumpkin left side. And he'll send Mason through the paint to the other side. Leave that left side all the way open for himself. Instead gives to Gilder at the top of the circle. Back to Lee. And Lee will take it in the paint. He will put on the brakes and then put up the shot. And that one off the glass, off the rim, and down. Tough shot inside for Malcolm Lee. Had to really create some space. Use his long arms to be able to put that one up. And it skidded in. 17-10. As Major pulls up behind the arc. Juan Patillo is checked on. He will take it to the hole. And he will be fouled by Benson. And that's 2 fouls on Keith Benson. So 2 players, 2 fouls each for the Skyforce, and that will prompt a substitution for the Skyforce as Benson will check out and Marcus Blakely will check on. Blakely, the All-Star, coming off the bench tonight, 6'5" out of the University of Vermont. And the first free throw for Patillo is good. Patillo is the leading rebounder for the Jam, along with 14.2 points per contest. He is 6'6" out of Western Kentucky and averaging 76% from the stripe. Drills the first and drills the second. 19-10, 5:40 to go, first quarter. And the Skyforce will play it in the far court. Pruitt, left side, now Blakely in the left corner. He's being hounded. He'll give it up to Anthony Mason Jr. From about 20 feet, he will take a couple of dribbles to the free throw line, keeps the bounce, gives it up to Lee, 7 to shoot. 5:25 left first quarter as Lee gets to the free throw line. The ball caroms up in the air, and with 1 second on the shot clock, it will be Skyforce basketball, but they'll have to inbound it near the scorer's table at midcourt. and it will actually be beyond midcourt when they have to get this in. Anthony Mason Jr. sitting up near the hash, and they have to tell him to go all the way down. So with one on the shot clock, Skyforce have to get it in and get it up. Mason gives it to Lee, and he does not get it off. And it did not hit rim, even if he had got it off in time. 5:17 left first quarter, and the shot clock violation gives it back to the Jam, and they lead it 19-10. Wise to Patillo. And Patillo holding left of the lane beyond the free throw line. Now we'll take it in the paint. Drives by Marcus Blakely. Missed the layup. Ooh, that was a bunny unobstructed, and he coughed it up. Lee gives it to Gilder. Here's a 17-footer. Right baseline is good. Gilder with 5 points, and it's 19-12. 4:50 to go in the first quarter. And Wise will take it to the side, and Will Voigt will call timeout for the Bakersfield Jam. 4:48 left first quarter. Timeout on the court as the Bakersfield Jam still hold a 7-point lead, 19-12, on the NBA Development League Radio Network. At the 4:48 mark of the first quarter, Bakersfield will have it following the timeout. They will have a substitution in their lineup. Osiris Eldridge has joined the lineup. He's a 6'3 guard out of Illinois State and has the most highest point total individually in any game this season with 52. Patillo, left baseline, trying to drive it on Mason, bounces it, and here's Gabe Pruitt to obstruct. Now we'll swing it around. Byers, three, off the mark. Rebound, Trey Gilder. And Gilder has it pop loose, but he does get it back. Skyforce stand pat after the timeout. Mustafa Farrakhan has also checked on for the Jam. He is a 6'4 guard out of Virginia. And there is a three put up by Gabe Pruitt, and he drills it from the left side. 19-15, 4:06 left in the first quarter as Farrakhan will run the point. He will point to the right, ask for the screen, doesn't come, and Byers will have it on the left wing. Byers dribbles away from two players, gives it up to a jumping Patillo, who lays it up and in from the left side. 21-15, 3:45 left in the first. Lee with Farrakhan within clutching distance. Now will take a bounce, keeps it in the right hand, and gets around the screen of Gilder. Lee will stop at the right block. Can't post up from there. Five to shoot. Pruitt's got to put it up. He does from behind the arc. He is fouled with one on the shot clock. And Osiris Eldridge with arms outstretched will be called. and three free throws for Gabe Pruitt. 3:28 left in the first quarter, and the Skyforce can cut the lead in half at the line if Pruitt can hit all three. Pruitt has been about 75% from the line this season. First one is off to the left. So a six-point lead it remains. Pruitt breathes a sigh and prepares for number two. Second one is short. A six-point lead still. Gabe Pruitt spent some time in training camp in the NBA. He was with the Orlando Magic for a time during the NBA lockout ending training camps during December. He finally gets one. So one of three for Pruitt and 21-16 with 3:25 left in the first. Farrakhan has it on the right side and he'll take it to the middle, shadowed there by Nick Covington, who's checked on for the Skyforce. And here's a three by Byers again. That one's too strong. Well, Byers hit his first three shots and has been cold ever since. 3:08 left in the first, and the Skyforce trail by five. Mason's going to take it in the paint to the jar, and he missed it. But he'll go to the line for two. That one just clung to the rim and fell off to the side. And Byers will be called, and that's team foul number four on the jam. So both teams will be in the penalty for the balance of this first quarter, which reads 3:02. Mason has been very good from the free throw line this season, 85% coming in, and he hits the first toss, 21-17. Second one is good, 21-18. Jammed to the front court. Farrakhan puts on the brakes, he'll pull up from 19, and it's good. Just left of the free throw line, Mustafa Farrakhan. And on the other end, ball is thrown away, and Anthony Mason Jr. ends up into the patrons along the baseline. 23-18, 2:47 remaining in the first quarter. Coming up the left side is Farrakhan, and Farrakhan will drive by Pruitt. Oh, and he missed the layup, and Farrakhan thought he was fouled, or at least he is outraged that he missed such an easy shot. Mason to the free throw line, gets it to the left side where Pruitt, he'll drive the lane, he'll lay it up, missed that one. And the rebound pulled down by Adrian Thomas. He's a 6'7 forward out of Miami. Here's the lob to Patillo, and it's raked away by Trey Gilder. 17 to shoot. Bakersfield will keep it on the baseline. 23-18. Well, both teams have had some point-blank shots. Thud off the rim in this first quarter. Bakersfield with their hot start has kept him in it. There's Thomas, and he'll drill it. That's a three from the left corner off the feed from the inbounds. So Adrian Thomas makes it 26-18. Skyforce led 1-0 in this game, and 9 points is the largest lead so far for Bakersfield in this first quarter. Covington drives the lane. He'll lay it up and in, and count that basket plus one more. Nick Covington, a 6'2 guard from Oklahoma City University. 8.4 points per game, gets two on the board quickly. And the foul will be whistled on Derek Byers, and that is his second. Covington's free throw, a couple of bounces on the rim. No one goes up there to slap it away, and it falls through, 26-21. Under 2 minutes left, first quarter, as the Jam play at front court, leading by five. Farrakhan picks it up at the top. Will be spelled by Byers. Now Eldridge gets some space, puts up the jumper. It's too strong. Rebound Blakely. Covington to the front court. He'll look it over. Keeps the bounce. Switches to the left hand and will retreat to the jump circle. 14 on the shot clock, and Blakely off the screen. Now has it dribble. Gives it up to Mason. Mason to free throw line. Loops a pass to Blakely. Jumper is good. Boy, tough work underneath for Marcus Blakely. Had a defender draped all over him. And a little English got that ball to fall through. 26-23, first bucket of the game for the All-Star. Marcus Blakely, 13.3 points per game coming in. Most of his time this season spent with the Iowa Energy. but now for the Skyforce. Eldridge gets to the free throw line, gives it off to Juan Patillo, who drills the ball through with the emphatic flush. Patillo with 6 points, 28-23. Under a minute left in the quarter. Off the curl, it's a catch and shoot for Pruitt. It's no good. Rebound, Patillo, and Patillo's going to steamroll front court. Gives it up, Eldridge, reverse layup is good. The drive in the dish works Patillo to Eldridge. 30-23, and now 40 seconds remain in quarter number one. Pruitt gives it up to Covington right side. He will take a dribble to his left, stopped at the free throw line, gives it up to Gilder, who will jump it from 20, swish. Trey Gilder, and the assist goes to Nick Covington. 30-25, and 3 seconds separate the two timepieces as we near the end of quarter number one. 12 on the shot clock as Farrakhan slows it down, waits for the opportunity to strike. Here comes Patillo on the screen, picked up by Blakely. Blakely knocks it away. Blakely's going to take it the other way. He's going to take it and stuff it through the 10. 4.1 left in the quarter. Osiris Eldridge gets to midcourt. He will weave his way through. Shot good if it goes. It's not good. Off the side of the iron as the Bakersfield Jam lead the Sioux Falls Skyforce by 3 after quarter number 1, 30-27. Back in 2 minutes with second quarter action on the D-League Radio Network. Sioux Falls Arena are our venue tonight in the Bakersfield Jam with a 30-27 lead after one quarter. Skyforce leading by 1-0 at the outset, but then the Jam able to push the lead to 19-10 during the course of that first quarter. Skyforce roaring back to shoot 43% in that first quarter, 10-23. Bakersfield cooled off, 12-20, 60%, still pretty good shooting. Rebounds, though, in favor of the Skyforce. They've got 15-10 for Bakersfield. Turnovers even at 3, and has netted 5 points for the Skyforce, 3 for the Jam. Leading scorers, Derek Byers, 8 for the Jam and 7 for Trey Gilder. Gilder's got 5 rebounds, and Byers has 4 rebounds. And underneath, Juan Patillo lays it up and in. Patillo adds to his point total, now has 8 points of his own. 32-27 as the Jam strike first in this second quarter. Blakely left of the lane, got a foul coming as Anthony Mason Jr. was held up by Derek Byers. Nope, they'll say Ronaldo Major on the foul. And Major will pick up his second personal foul. Mason will give it up off the sideline to Gabe Pruitt. And Gabe Pruitt back to the basket. Osiris Eldridge shadowing him. He'll give it off to Gilder. Five to shoot. Gilder takes it in the lane, loses the handle, and Bakersfield the steal with Eldridge. Eldridge has a man running with him. Oh, and he fires a pass off to Mark DiPatillo, and he'll slow it down. Ronaldo Major stopped by two defenders from going into the lane, and they'll set it up. Farrakhan gets to the free throw line, gives it up. Eldridge, three. It's good. Osiris Eldridge. 5 points for Eldridge, and it's 35-27. First 5 points of the second quarter, courtesy of the Bakersfield Jam. Will the Skyforce answer? No, the ball knocked away. Brian Hamilton out of Louisiana Lafayette has it knocked away. And the Jam bring it front court. Here's another three and another make for Adrian Thomas. Adrian Thomas with 6 points. And the Jam have their first double-digit lead of the night, 11 points, 38-27. Gilder, here's a 20-footer, and it's off the mark. Rebound, Farrakhan tracks it down in the corner, and the Jam will bring it front court. Farrakhan will give it off to Juan Patillo, who has his shot knocked away, and then two defenders rip it away from Patillo for the putback. Hamilton the other way for the Skyforce, and they're going to call a blocking foul as Hamilton gets to the right block. And Farrakhan ends up on the deck, and Farrakhan leaked to the spot. He'll be whistled for the foul. And they'll take it from the side. Second team foul on Bakersfield, but it was not in the act, according to the officials. Pruitt, right wing, has Eldridge in front of him. Now they get it down to Blakely on the baseline. Baseline into the double team. Blakely has to cut it loose. Gilder's open to the rack, and he'll lay it up and in.
Trey Gilder.
The double team came. Blakely found the open man. 38-29. 9:45 left second quarter. Farrakhan gets the screen from Patillo. Gives it off to Thomas. Back to Farrakhan. He'll jump the three. It's too strong. Rebound Hamilton. And the Skyforce run it the other way. Hamilton, though, will slow it down. It cuts cross midcourt. And Pruitt will bounce pass it to Blakely. He will fire it from the left side, and it's good. A 19-footer for Marcus Blakely. Blakely with 6 points, and it's 38-31. Skyforce, the last 4 points on the board. Farrakhan looking left, will send it left to Eldridge, and Eldridge will try to drive on Hamilton. Gets past him. Hamilton knocks it away from behind and off of Eldridge out of bounds. 9:04 left in the first quarter. And the Skyforce with a defensive stand and can further decrease the Bakersfield lead on this trip. Jeremy Wise will check back on for Bakersfield, and so will Vanderbeeken and Cook, Byers, and Major. And so the starting five back on for the Jam. Here's a three for Gabe Pruitt. That one's off the front iron, and the rebound to Hamilton. And so the Skyforce pick up another offensive board, cutting through the lane, Pruitt, and he is raked from behind. And I believe Pruitt will be called, or rather, no, they will not do free throws. They'll send it in from the side. They'll say not on the act. That is foul number three in the period for Bakersfield, and that is the first personal foul on Jeremy Wise. Now they will change it, and they will say in the act they were setting up to inbound it from the side, but someone must have got some lobbying done. And so Pruitt will go to the free throw line, try to atone from his 1-of-3 performance earlier. He had a 3-point shot, was fouled in the act, hit 1-of-3, and that one rattles in and out of the cylinder. So he'll try again. Still a 7-point game, 38-31 with 8:44 left in the second quarter. Pruitt, the second attempt, that one rattles home. Wise to the front court as Bakersfield leads it by 6. Vanderbeeken, now Major, left side. Major with a pump fake, and he will take the drive. He will pull up just inside the free throw line. Too strong. Should have just stopped a couple of inches near the free throw line. He'd have got that one. Ball passed through the lane, and it's tipped away by Cook. Skyforce will keep it from the baseline. Dominique Coleman will check back in. He's got two personal fouls. Gabe Pruitt will take a seat on the bench. Pruitt injured his ankle before the All-Star break, missed a couple of games, and has seen some good court time here tonight. Coleman gets it in, Blakely, and with 15 to shoot, Blakely will roll the pass to Anthony Mason Jr. on the left baseline. Back to Blakely, back to Mason. Mason turns, fires, and it's too strong. Rebound tipped, but it's saved by Byers. And Bakersfield will run at front court. Byers still in control, and he will give it up. Nice pass as Ronaldo Major slipped between the defenders and was able to lay it up. That was all set up by a nice look by Byers as he shielded what he was going to do, and Major was able to capitalize. Into the paint, Mason. Gilder will bail him out. Now back to Coleman, nine to shoot as Blakely has it. Left of the lane, jumper is too strong. Rebound, Major. And the Jam leading by eight, 40 to 32, front court. 7:39 to go in the second quarter. Into the lane, Cook, and the call, blocking foul on Dominique Coleman. And that is three on DC. Will there be a move from the bench? Maybe, maybe not. We know that Malcolm Lee from the Minnesota Timberwolves on assignment has his minutes limited by design, but he will enter the ballgame. Will they allow the substitution, though? Well, yeah, they're going to have, say, Cook was in the act. So before we have free throws, we'll have infection control. So there will be a brief timeout. It looks like they will attend to Trey Gilder. Over on the side. Nope, that's not Gilder. That's Brian Hamilton, who's being tended to by by the trainer Dustin Schramm. 40 to 32 as the Bakersfield Jam leads the Sioux Falls Skyforce from the arena. I'm Dan Peters. This is the only game in this homestand for the Skyforce. After tonight, they will send off for a couple of games with the Erie Bayhawks. They will play Saturday in the evening and a matinee on Sunday. While the Bakersfield Jam, their next opponents will be the Reno Bighorns, and they will play another similar Saturday-Sunday engagement that will be in Reno. Their next home contest for the Bakersfield Jam will be Friday, March 9th against the Dakota Wizards, and then they'll face the Idaho Stampede the next night on the 10th, and then they'll have another home game against Rio Grande Valley on March the 16th. After tonight, the next home game for Sioux Falls will be March the 13th, against the Erie Bayhawks. Now, are they going to allow the substitution yet? I think they have to have the free throw be attempted first, so they're going to get this right. The officials will not allow the substitution. They'll put Lee at the scorer's table, and Coleman will hop off the bench and be on the floor while the free throw will be put up by Adam Cook. Cook has been very good from the free throw line, 82% on the season. Free throw is good. One thing about Bakersfield that is, I don't know if you'd say a luxury or unique to them, but they have six players in their lineup that have played at least 30 games for them this season. Adam Cook being one of those. And they have seven who have played at least 25 games. Jeremy Wise, the other one that played less than 30 games. Jeremy Wise was in camp during the NBA lockout end. Second free throw good for Cook, and underneath, Marcus Blakely will get two at the line. And they're going to call it on Jamie Vanderbeeken, his first. So Blakely was in the act, he'll shoot. That's the fourth team foul on the Jam, so the penalty applies to the Jam for the balance of the period. Blakely coming out with a wrap on his left calf. His first free throw is no good. Blakely with 6 points in the ballgame so far. And Blakely's second toss is good. He adjusted to whatever ailed him in the first free throw and got it perfect. 42-33. 7:16 and ticking in the second quarter. As Byers looks to the right, he will dribble it to the free throw line. Has the ball sneak away and out of bounds, they'll say off of Sioux Falls. And the officials are getting an earful. They're saying that's escaped Byers' hands, and they'll say there was contact from one of the Skyforce players before It went out of bounds. Wise will trigger it right of the hoop. Wise is looking, can't find anybody, now gets it into Byers. Byers has to lift up his toes to be able to keep his feet in bounds. He'll drive the lane, score it. Byers with 10. 44-33, and the largest lead of the game for the second time tonight, maintained by the Bakersfield Jam, 11 points. Malcolm Lee gets it off to Gilder. Gilder will drive it left side of the lane. His shot just off the iron. And we got a foul underneath. They'll call a loose ball foul on the Jam. And Blakely, I believe, will go to the line. And Jeremy Wise will pick up foul number two. So Blakely back to the stripe where he hit one of two just moments ago. Already has five rebounds tonight. And the first free throw, no doubter. Keith Benson is going to check into the lineup for the Sioux Falls Skyforce. And Trey Gilder will get his first rest of the night. 10-point game. And now it's still a 10-point game. The second free throw, Karam's out of the lane, but picked up by Adam Cook. And Wise will bring it front court. So another half-and-half trip for Blakely, and it makes it 44-34. Vanderbeeken left to the lane in the high post. Gives it off to Byers. Byers has to reel in an errant pass out of bounds to Bakersfield. Blakely and Hamilton trying to cleave their case. 7 to shoot for the Bakersfield Jam as they try to get it in with 6:26 left in the second. Wise looking. Wise gets it into Major. Major has to fumble it, get it back, got it in, and one more. Ronaldo Major kept working down low, and he will get his reward. And for Major, that is point number 8 on the night. Chance to get 9, and Hamilton will pick up the foul. And Major, who had surgery a couple of years ago to fix a leaky heart valve, has been working his way back. Man, he was this close to getting into the NBA on a full-time basis before that heart valve incident. But Major gets a three-point play, and it makes it 47-34. Timeout on the court, 6:19 left, second quarter, and we'll return in 2 minutes on the D-League Radio Network. Sioux Falls Skyforce against the Bakersfield Jam from the Sioux Falls Arena. Hello to you, I'm Dan Peters. Thanks for joining us tonight. It's Skyforce basketball, and they trail 13 points, 47-34. Malcolm Lee has given it up to Keith Benson. Off the curl, Mason, jumper, good. Hit it from straight away from 17 feet. And off the timeout, the Skyforce make it 47-36. Mason with 6 points. Into the lane, Ronaldo Major on the reverse, using his length to flip it up and in. Major with 6 in the quarter. He's got 10 in the game. Jumper quickly on the other end. Brian Hamilton hits it from the right side from 15 feet. Hamilton's first bucket of the game, 49-38. 5:34 and ticking second quarter as Major with Hamilton draped on him. Dribbles around him, picked up by Blakely. Now they'll send it around to Wise on the left side. Wise gets around the screen. Vanderbeeken, he will fire the three. It's a good from the left side, right in that angle where it cuts towards the center of the court. And that's where Jamie Vanderbeeken makes it 52-38, largest lead of the game, 14 points for the Bakersfield Jam. Bakersfield heating up again. They hit their first 6 shots of the night. Lee with 8 to shoot, 5 minutes left in the second quarter. Here's Hamilton with a jumper. That one's short. Rebound picked up by Byers. Long lead pass. Adam Cook, he will lay it up and in. And Cook with 5 points, and the lead grows yet again. 54-38. And a triple four is left in the second quarter. Benson, he will fire from 17. That one's off the mark. Rebound pulled down by Byers, and Bakersfield will bring it front court. Byers is open. He will fire the three. Good launch. Derek Byers, his third three-pointer of the game, and he's got 13 points, 57-38. And after that timeout, the Skyforce have given up a bunch. They scored a bucket, but then have given it up to the tune of 9 straight points. Benson, right block. No shot there. Hamilton gives it up to Mason. He will fire the three, and that one's too strong. Rebound will carry him to Byers, and Byers is fouled, and they're going to call it on Mason. And that is his first. Four minutes left in the second quarter, and it's a 19-point game, 57-38. Mason will take a seat on the bench, and to replace him, Trey Gilder has returned. Wise gives it up to Byers, kicks to the corner Thomas, and Vanderbeeken, he'll fire another three. That one's short. The rebound on the weak side. They're going to call a loose ball foul against Adam Cook. He is in somewhat disbelief, and it will be a penalty against the Jam. And it will put the Skyforce at the line. Marcus Blakely will toe the stripe. Marcus, 2 of 4 so far from the line. Not too far from his average from the stripe. Swish is the first. Now with 9 points and can get into twin figures with a make here. And the second toss, that one's good. 57-40, 17-point Bakersfield lead. 3:40 to go in the second quarter. Vanderbeeken, Adrian Thomas, he will drive, gets to the free throw line, stops just inside the line. That one kicks off the heel and then pops back down the pipe. Thomas with 8, 59-40. Malcolm Lee has it for the Skyforce. He's on the left wing. Looks to drive the lane, gets inside his man, leaves it off for Benson, and he is rejected soundly. To the other way, to Bakersfield Jam. Jeremy Wise with a nice dish. But the play is thwarted by the Skyforce's Gabe Pruitt, who prevented Byers from getting to the rack. Let's pause 10 seconds for stations to identify themselves on the NBA Development League Radio Network. Give you an idea what a spectacle that pass was that Jeremy Wise unleashed. He was just across the timeline, and he had to extend his arms and really give a lot of English on that pass to get it around the defender and get it to the right spot where Derek Byers could do something with it. Sweet pass. Byers makes one of two at the line. Misses the first, makes the second. 60-40, and the lead has broached the 20-point mark for the Bakersfield Jam. 3 minutes and ticking in the second quarter. As Lee licks it over from the right wing, still with a bounce, low dribble, takes it all the way in, lays it up and in. Uses the left hand as he drove the center of the lane. 60-42 with 2:46 left in the quarter. Byers has the ball nipped away, and Lee comes out of the stack. He'll give it up to Blakely. Blakely missed the dunk, and the rebound comes to Adam Cook. And Jeremy Wise will calmly swish the jump shot from the free throw line as he pulled up in transition. There's a four-point swing. Blakely misses, and Wise connects. His first bucket of the game is Wise. Wise did not shoot very well last night against Dakota. Was 1 of 13. 62-42. They haven't needed him tonight. Here's Malcolm Lee in a jumper from the right side. It's no good. Rebound. The Jam with 2:06 left in the second quarter. Wise sizes it up, takes, and then has the ball escape, but Bakersfield comes away with it. Here comes another drive to the bucket, and Derek Byers will go to the line when we come back from a timeout. 1:57 remaining, second quarter, and Bakersfield can build on a 20-point lead, 62-42. We'll have that for you in 2 minutes on the NBA Development League Radio Network. Bakersfield Jam have been continuing their hot stroke from the floor. They shot 60% in the first quarter, and they've been able to continue that and better here in the second. They are 12 of 16 from the floor in this quarter alone. 12 of 16. And from downtown, they are 4 of 6 in this quarter alone. That'll build you a 20-point lead, especially when the Skyforce are 39% for the game, 15 of 39. Byers cans the first free throw, 63-42. Lead moves to 21 for the first time tonight. And Byers, the second, is good as well. Make it a 22-point game, 64-42. As Byers works his way to 16 points so far in the night. Lee, left's right side, gives it off to the left to Pruitt. Pruitt, he will stop from 20 with a high jump and a high arcing shot, and it goes for Gabe Pruitt. 7 for Gabe, and it's 64-44. Mustafa Farrakhan, he will give it off to Thomas, who will jump it from 3. Shot inside, no good by Byers. Tried to acrobatically tip it back in, wasn't quite able to get there. Marcus Blakely there to lay it in on the nice feed from Malcolm Lee. So Malcolm Lee the dish, and the recipient, Marcus Blakely, has 12. 64-46, Mustafa Farrakhan in a late whistle here, and they're going to call a foul as Blakely, with palms outstretched in disbelief. But Blakely will be whistled for his first. Farrakhan to the line. 1:10 left in the second quarter. And Farrakhan can build the lead back to 20 points with a couple of makes here. Farrakhan about 69% from the line this season. Hits the first. What was interesting about these two teams when they first played back in the mid-January time, it was a game where neither team really got a run going. But this time, Bakersfield able to work the run to their advantage. Jimmy Agunye getting his first action of the night. Agunye is a 6'9 forward out of Oral Roberts. Lee will give it up to Blakely. Blakely bounces, and the ball caroms off of Agunye. And to the front court comes the Bakersfield Jam. And that one whistles out of bounds off of Sioux Falls. And the Jam will keep it in their front court with 49.3 left in quarter number two. 65-46 the score. A 19-point game after Farrakhan missed one of two and the Skyforce throw it away in their front court. Here comes Ronaldo Major. Count that bucket. As he jumped it from just inside the dotted line, faded to his left, and was able to get it off the glass. And Major with 12 points on the night. Make that 13 points on the night for Ronaldo Major. And Major can complete the three-point play. He does not. 67-46, and the clock ticks under 40 seconds. As Malcolm Lee drives the paint, he will lay it up and score. Lee with 6 points, and 67-48. 33 seconds left in the quarter as Mustafa Farrakhan with a wide dribble gives it up to Thomas. He'll fire the three. Swish! Adrian Thomas. His third three-pointer of the game. And he's got 11. 70-48. Bakersfield lighting it up tonight. Malcolm Lee will leak some time out of the clock. 8 on the shot clock, and he'll get to the right side of the lane, loop it up, missed it, ball tapped around, and Blakely trying to put it up. Gilder get the put back, it's no good, and we've got a foul underneath. And they're going to call it on Thomas, and that is his first. To the line will go Trey Gilder, and he will shoot a pair with 2.2 seconds left before intermission. Gilder on the night has 9 points so far. And his first toss, a couple of bounces, but does find its way to the twine. 70-49. The Bakersfield Jam now lead it by 20 again. 70-59 as Gilder hits a pair. They get it to the timeline. Eldridge will hoist it, and it will beat the red, but it does not go. And that's the second time Eldridge has had a shot at the red, but does not get it to go. Just grazing it off to the left both times. You'll have to calibrate that at halftime. But Bakersfield has not missed much tonight. 70-50 is their current score. They lead by 20 at the break. We'll take a 2-minute timeout and we'll return with our halftime scoring statistics, and they are interesting to say the least. And we'll also catch you up on the other games going tonight in the NBA Development League. We'll do that in 2 minutes on the D-League Radio Network. Don't be a man of money quarterback. Talk about how you can hear a speaker.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Star Performance Complex.
Thanks to engineer Scott Zahn tonight, and it is 70-50, Sioux Falls Skyforce, trailing the Bakersfield Jam here at the Sioux Falls Arena. I'm Dan Peters. Thanks for joining us tonight. Well, 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 you don't have to go too much farther than the shooting statistics to figure out this one. Although the Skyforce have a pile of offensive rebounds, that hadn't helped much. Bakersfield has been smoking hot from the floor, 26 of 41, and that is 63% in the first half. And 9 of 17 from downtown, 53%. A far cry from what they were last night against the Dakota Wizards, as they ended sub 40% for the game last night. So they have improved their stroke. Probably needed a game to be able to get the rust off and be able to work their way back into shooting four, as the Jam hold a 20-point lead after one half of play. Skyforce were 18 of 44 in the first half, 40.9%, and from behind the arc, they were 1 of 5. As far as the scoring goes, 16 points for Derek Byers. And he was 5 of 9 from the floor, 3 of 5 from downtown, and 3 of 4 from the line. Byers already with a double-double. He's got 10 rebounds and 4 assists. So Byers filling it up tonight for the Jam. Two other players in double figures for the Jam after the first half. Ronaldo Majors got 13 points. And then 11 for Adrian Thomas. And Thomas off the bench for the Jam. 8 points off the bench for Juan Patillo. And then 6 points apiece for Adam Cook and Jamie Vanderbeeken. And then 3 for Mustafa Farrakhan. And 2 for Jeremy Wise. Jeremy Wise, though, has been able to distribute, dishing out 7 assists so far. As Bakersfield overall has been fantastic at sharing the ball tonight. They have 19 assists against their 5 turnovers. That'll win you a lot of games, too. And, of course, that's probably not a secret as to how Bakersfield has been able to get good shots. They have assisted 19 on their 26 baskets. And, of course, some of those baskets have been... Some of those baskets have been of the bunny variety that they have missed. So this lead for Bakersfield could be a lot bigger than what it is at 20 points right now. The Skyforce is 12 points. Marcus Blakely leading the way. A 4 of 8 shooting for Marcus. Trey Gilder, 4 of 7 shooting. With 11 points on the night. 7 for Gabe Pruitt off the bench. Blakely's 12 off the bench as well. 6 points apiece for Anthony Mason Jr. and Malcolm Lee. Lee also has the most assists for the Skyforce in 3. three for Keith Benson, three for Nick Covington off the bench, and then two for Brian Hamilton. Dominique Coleman starting tonight for the Sky Force, but saddled with foul trouble. And Yemi Agunye with 3 minutes played in the latter stages of the second quarter, but not getting a score on the board tonight. Other significant statistics tonight. Skyforce have gotten to the line 20 times, have shot 13, makes 9 of 12 for Bakersfield at the line tonight. And the rebounds, Sioux Falls has picked up 28 rebounds to 23 for the Bakersfield Jam. Sioux Falls 10 offensive rebounds. While the turnovers, Sioux Falls with 6 and Bakersfield with 5. Those 6 turnovers led to 11 points for the Jam and 6 points for the Skyforce off the turnovers. Biggest lead so far to the night, Bakersfield with 22 points spread for their largest, and the Skyforce led it 1-0. The lead has changed hands one time. We were tied twice so far in the contest. 70-50, the Bakersfield Jam lead the Sioux Falls Skyforce. We'll be back in 2 minutes with more in our halftime on the NBA Development League Radio Network. Halftime at the Sioux Falls Arena, and the score is 70-50. The Sioux Falls Skyforce trailing the Bakersfield Jam. The visitors come out smoking in the first half of play, shooting 63% from the floor. This copyrighted broadcast of the NBA Development League LLC may not be retransmitted, reproduced, rebroadcast, or otherwise distributed or used in any form without the express written consent of the NBA Development League. At halftime, the Texas Legends, surviving the initial onslaught from the Austin Toros, and now the Legends have the lead, 52-48 at the break. And the Austin Toros and their 48 points. They are led by Leo Lyons, who has 13 points, and Lyons also with 7 rebounds on the night. The Texas Legends, they are led tonight by Antonio Daniels, and Daniels has 11 points at the break. Leading rebounder is Anthony Vereen. While the Canton Charge look to send Iowa to another defeat, why the Iowa Energy have not, well, they've been kind of, you could say, kind of, I hate to say mediocre, but you can say that. They've kind of been 2-3 in their last five games, and they lost their last time out against the Dakota Wizards. Canton Charge hold a 115-102 edge with 125 left in their contest. Canton Charge being led by Travis Franklin, who's got 25 points. And Ben Strong is leading Iowa with 23 points and 7 rebounds tonight. Curtis Stinson with 8 assists in their contest. Dante Milligan with 10 rebounds. And T.J. Campbell with 10 assists to lead Canton tonight. So it looks like the Canton Charge leading by 13 with under 2 minutes left on their way to a victory tonight to tighten things up in the Eastern Conference. Canton is 4.5 games back and at a .500 record. Iowa 21-12. With the Canton looking to get closer. Here at the Sioux Falls Arena, the score is the Bakersfield Jam 70 and the Canton the Sioux Falls Skyforce 50. Back in 2 minutes with the third quarter on the NBA Development League Radio Network. Time just about done, and we're going to have third quarter action from the Sioux Falls Arena in moments. I'm Dan Peters. Thanks for joining us for the NBA Development League Radio Network, and also for those of you listening and viewing on the NBA Futurecast tonight. The only other contest being played tonight in the NBA Development League, just underway, as the LA Defenders lead the Idaho Stampede 16-14 just past midway in the first quarter. Now under a minute. The Canton, as the Charge, lead Iowa by a 117-105 score. Travis Franklin now padding his point total with 27 points for the Canton Charge. He's come up big. Well, after tonight's ball games, next up on the NBA Development League schedule for the respective teams, Sioux Falls Skyforce will take to the road. They'll play four straight away from the arena. They'll play at Erie Saturday, Sunday, and then they'll play two at Austin with a gap in between the games. Thursday, March 8th, and then a Saturday afternoon game on the 10th. And then return home for a single game against the Erie Bayhawks on March the 13th. Bakersfield Jam They've got Reno next on their travel itinerary after the All-Star break. Hit Dakota last night. Sioux Falls tonight, two at Reno, and then back to the Bakersfield events, the Jam Event Center, for contest on March 9th against the Wizards. Bakersfield leading by 20, and they've got the ball to start quarter number three. Wise gives it up to Vanderbeeken, jumps it for three, and Vanderbeeken hits again! His third three-point bucket of the night, and it's 73-50. Vanderbeeken firing from the outside on all five of his attempts, and he's hit three of them. 73-50, largest lead of the night for the Jam. Malcolm Lee looking it over from the right side, keeps the bounce, crosses over, and then whips the pass away, and they'll say it was out of bounds to Bakersfield. And they're trying to lobby that the ball was tipped, but they'll say no joy. Bakersfield basketball, and we played our first two possessions of this third quarter. 40 seconds elapsed, and Bakersfield leads it by 23. Byers reels it in with a left hand, kicks it out, and there's Ronaldo Major, 10 to shoot. He's double-teamed, gets it away to Byers. They get it to Vanderbeeken. Wise is going to drive. Wise will lay it off for Adam Cook, and he is rejected, and they're going to give a whistle underneath. They're going to say jump, jump ball. Adam Cook looking for a foul as he brought the ball up hard, and the ball was met with equal resistance from Trey Gilder. So it's Trey Gilder, 6'9" out of Northwestern State, against Adam Cook, 6'8" out of Northern Iowa. Ball goes to the corner and tracked down by Anthony Mason Jr. Skyforce the basketball, trailing by 23. Marcus Blakely is in the lineup for the Skyforce to start this second half. And he gets the ball from the pass from Anthony Mason Jr. Jumper in the lane, too strong, rebound Byers. Byers has it stolen away by Malcolm Lee, and up ahead to Marcus Blakely. Into the 10 it goes with a left hand for Marcus. Blakely with 14, 73-52, 10:30 to go, third quarter. As Byers trying to clear some space, his double team gives it away Vanderbeeken. This time he shoots from inside the arc. Oh man, that one was short. Vanderbeeken needs to stay outside that arc. Malcolm Lee looked for the lob, couldn't get it to Blakely. Instead, he'll give it up to Gilder, who'll fire from 19. That one's off the mark. Rebound Cook. Wise to the other end of the court. And he will keep the dribble. Now give it up Vanderbeeken. Oh, there's that three. In and out. Vanderbeeken, that was tough nuts. He couldn't quite get that one to drop. 73-52. 9:52 left, third quarter. Keith Benson gives it up to Lee. Lee spins in the lane, gives it off to Benson, and he loses the handle. Rebound, or rather the steal, comes to Wise. And Wise has it knocked away by Malcolm Lee. It's a two-on-one. And Malcolm Lee takes it all the way himself. Missed the layup, and Menson has it knocked out of there, but Gilder there to track it down. Gilder's going to take it all the way in the paint, and he will put it up and in, score! Draw the foul, and Jamie Vanderbeeken will send Trey Gilder to the line for an and-one. Gilder with 13. And the score reads 73-54. Gilder to the line, where he is 3 of 4, 4 of 5, as he completes the three-point play. 14 for Gilder, now tied with leading scoring honors with Marcus Blakely, 14 apiece. 73-55, as Major holds it right side. Double team, and we get a foul. Will it be either Mason or Benson? They'll say Mason. Mason's second. Benson's got two of his own, but Mason will be whistled for that one. Clock reads 9:13, yet to resume. Now it does as the ball comes inbound. Wise with a left-handed dribble, takes it towards the left wing, will switch to the right and then work his way to the right. Ball tipped by Blakely. He's got Malcolm Lee as a running man. Behind the back pass to Marcus Blakely, who finishes with authority.
Thank you, Malcolm Lee, and timeout.
Blakely, 16 points. And the lead is 73-57, a somewhat comfortable 16-point edge for the Jam. But there's still time remaining. back in 2 minutes after the timeout on the NBA Development League Radio Network. Seven, 8:59 left, third quarter. The Bakersfield Jam scoring the first 3 points of this third frame, but the Skyforce have answered with the next seven. 8:50 to go as Wise controls on the right wing, gives it up to Byers on the left wing. Byers with a couple of dribbles into the double team, and he'll pass it to nobody. Into the Patrons. Actually, the Patrons just kind of stuck his legs out to kick the ball back into play. 73-57. And the Skyforce with Benson. Free throw line, left of the lane, in the high post. Couple of bounces, works his way in the lane, over Vanderbeek and scores it. Keith Benson with five, and it's 73-59. So it's a 9-point run for Sioux Falls here in this third quarter. Wise with his shadow near the timeline, works it left side, stolen away by Blakely, behind the back pass to Malcolm Lee, he will throw it down, and another timeout called by the Bakersfield Jam, as the active hands of the Skyforce have produced an 11-point run here in the third quarter, 73-61. This will be of the shortened variety, so we will stay close as the Skyforce trying to bring themselves closer to the Bakersfield Jam. It's a 12-point game, 73-61. Blakely, Lee, Story, the last two times down the court, exciting the faithful here at the arena. The Cats in Charge finish off the Iowa Energy tonight. 122-107, the final score. Travis Franklin leads the charge with 29 points, while Ben Strong goes big for the Iowa Energy, 25 points and 8 rebounds. So the Energy dropped to 21-13. And have won only two of their last six games. And the Cannon Charge have won five of their last six. And now work their way above 500, going to 18-17. Lou Mustafa Farrakhan is checked back in, and the shot down low to Patillo. Count that bucket, he'll go to the line. And Malcolm Lee will pick up the foul, his first. And 75-61 the score. Patillo to the line to complete the 3-point play. And Patillo does. He is 3 of 3 from the stripe tonight. 11 points, 76-61. Now it's a 15-point lead. A little bit of pressure in backcourt, and it's broken. Very good! Malcolm Lee with the lob to Marcus Blakely. 76-63. And Blakely continues his prowess. He's got 18. And the ball off the floor, and Mustafa Farrakhan loses the handle. Turnover, gives it back to Sioux Falls. Skyforce can cut it down to 11 on this trip. Even 10 with a long bomb. They haven't been very proficient at that yet tonight. Blakely has it above the arc, and the ball in and out of the hands of Mason. Blakely there to tap it away. Other end to Gilder. Gilder up and in. Blakely has been the catalyst defensively here in this third quarter, and it's an 11-point game, 76-65. Farrakhan picks it up, gives it away to Eldridge. Eldridge drives the lane, shoots, and in and out. Rebound, Petillo tapped it up, can't get it. Petillo tracks it down. Fresh shot clock for the Bakersfield Jam. Eldridge takes it in the lane, is rejected by Benson. He says, no, sir, that is not allowed. 6:40 to go in the quarter, and the Skyforce can get it to single digits. Blakely, left wing, he will jump it from 20. It's short. Rebound, Eldridge. And Eldridge will look it over. He'll pick up the pace, and the ball tapped away this time. Lee is able to jump it. And now the ball is on the floor. Skyforce basketball. Malcolm Lee, he's got Gilder on the wing. Lee will take it himself, and he will miss the layup. Had to flip it up with the right hand, kind of backhandedly, and the shot went awry. On the other end, Ronaldo Major gets in the paint, and he'll be fouled. He'll go to the line. Boy, a chance for Malcolm Lee to blow the lid off this place. Get the Skyforce underneath double digits in deficit. Still at 76-65 with 6:07 left in the third quarter. Marcus Blakely with 18. And Trey Gilder with 16. But still, it's a 15-6 run to start this third quarter for the Skyforce to chop that 20-point lead down to 11. From the side, Bakersfield will inbound it. Major will trigger it. Farrakhan, the recipient. Farrakhan keeps it in the left hand, switches to the right, and now we'll take it towards the right wing. Now in the lane, and he is rejected by Benson! And Keith Benson with a couple of swats here in this third quarter. It's like the Skyforce have tightened it up defensively. Gabe Pruitt is on for the Skyforce. He replaces Malcolm Lee. Here's a jumper in the corner. It's no good. Rebound Pruitt. As Adrian Thomas, who's checked on, unable to connect from long distance. Second opportunity for Sioux Falls to get under 10 points in the margin. Anthony Mason into two defenders, has the ball whistle out of Keith Benson's hands, nine to shoot. Gilder gives it to Blakely, and we've got Keith Benson on a push. No, 3-second violation. Benson camped in the lane. So Sioux Falls will employ some pressure in backcourt in the form of Blakely and Pruitt, and they get it into Eldridge. He will take it front court. Eldridge weaved his way toward the lane, retreats. Now will attack. He will get to the lane, into Mason, and Mason will be charged with a foul. And that's number three. 76-65 with 5:29 left third quarter. That is foul number four against the Skyforce. Next one puts them in the penalty. Adrian Thomas from Vanderbilt will try to launch it from long range. Off the front iron, rebound Gilder. And Gilder will get it out of trouble. Pruitt will set it up. He'll work his way right side. Look to attack, will pick up the dribble instead. Blakely, right baseline, will turn towards the basket, gives it up to Gilder. Dotted line jumper is off the mark. Rebound, Ronaldo Major, and Eldridge will take it to the front court. Major, now to Farrakhan. Farrakhan looking left side, gives it up to Major. Major wants to break down Benson, will take it right into him, and the ball, they will say, goaltending. Well, no offensive foul. As they will say, Major committed the foul as he drove right into Keith Benson. No, excuse me. They will not call the foul. They will say basket is good as Blakely got that ball on the way down. So it is basket good for Ronaldo Major, 78-65. 4:50 to go, third quarter. Timeout on the court. Back in 2 minutes on the NBA Development League Radio Network.
The Skyforce and Dakota Beverage would like to welcome Vantage Point Solutions. 652 people, and that's Private Bar and Catering. For available dates, contact the Skyforce at 332-0605. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Sky Leaders.
Let us put your name on our level. 78-65 as the Skyforce against Token Pressure in backcourt, kind of a zone press, and Bakersfield will melt back into the half-court set. 78-65, 4:35 and ticking as Gabe Pruitt looks to the right, will give it to the left side, Blakely. Now back up top to Pruitt, and Pruitt pulls up for the jumper. It's off to the right and out of bounds. Hit the side of the iron. And Sioux Falls had two opportunities to get the Bakersfield lead, which had grown to as big as 23 to start the third quarter, down to under 10 points, but now it stands at 13. Steele on the other end is losing the handle as Thomas, and the Skyforce come front court. Pruitt sends it to his man Mason on the right. Blakely right baseline. Basely in the double team, and there's a 19-footer for Keith Benson. Keith Benson from near the top of the circle, in the jump circle in the front court, makes it 78-67. Thomas, he'll jump from three, and it's good. Adrian Thomas, fourth three-point basket of the game. He's got 14 points, 81-67. 3:34 left in this third quarter. Benson in the double team, escapes the double team, and then is brought down by Osiris Eldridge as Benson went up for the score. No. So as Osiris Eldridge picks up his second personal foul, it is the second team foul on the jam, and Benson to the line. And Benson will put it up with the right hand, gritting his teeth as he let it go. Missed the shot. He knew that one was a little off. Rattled in and out of the cylinder. 81-67 it remains. 3:29 left in the quarter. Derek Byers is checked back on for the jam. And Jamie Vanderbeeken is also back on the floor. Jeremy Wise is also in. Second one is good for Benson. Eight for Keith Benson, and it's 81-68. Wise. Now Vanderbeeken, left of the circle, and off the curl, here comes Byers, and Byers gives it up to Wise, right wing. Wise, he will pull up, and we got a whistle, and he's going to be called for a carry. Turnovers now at 16 for the Bakersfield Jam. Sioux Falls has 10 committed so far. 3:10 to go, and it's 81-68. Mason, left corner, takes a couple of dribbles to his right, still with a right-handed bounce. Loops a pass to Benson at the free throw line, back to Mason, and he's called for steps. Got to put that ball down first before you make your move. 2:59 left, third quarter. And the lead stands at 13, 81-68. Sioux Falls able to decrease the lead with some defense here in this third quarter, but Bakersfield has been able to withstand the onslaught to this point. Vanderbeeken has Marcus Blakely all over him, some ball pressure. Now Byers, now here's two players. Now we've got almost like a two-point takedown. Are they going to call a foul on Gilder, or are they going to jump it? I think they're going to call a foul on Gilder. Gilder ended up on the floor with Adrian Thomas. Thomas with his rear end on the deck, and Derek Byers on the deck. Byers will go to the line to shoot a pair. But if Gilder hadn't been able to get both mitts on the ball without contact, that would have been a jump. As it stands, Byers at the line, where he hits on the first. Now that's number 17 on the night. First point of the second half for Derek Byers. And Byers from Vanderbilt. That one, that was off to the right and then just kind of kicked to the left and down through. So a pair for Byers. 83-68, 15-point game. As Pruitt works his way right side. Now back to Blakely up top. Blakely gives it off Benson. Up and too strong. Benson back up and in. And Benson with 7 in the quarter. And he's got 10 in the ball game. 83-70. Wise looking right side for the jam. Takes a step back and switches to the left hand. Keeps it with a left hand in the bounce. Now a two-handed pass knocked out away and out of bounds by Trey Gilder. 9 on the shot clock with 2:08 left in the third quarter, and it's 83-70. And the jam to get it in near the scorer's table. Gets it into Vanderbeeken, and Byers on the return. Byers is going to take it and is going to be thwarted. Oh, and Trey Gilder is upset. Byers a little out of control, and Gilder is going to be called for his second. Gilder thought he had that one picked clean. Excuse me, not his second. That's his fourth. I apologize. So Gilder with 4 personals. It does not appear, though, that Coach Mo McCone will go to the bench to replace Trey Gilder. Byers cans the first. 84-70. .203 showing in this third quarter as Byers prepares for the second time. That one's good. No doubter. 85-70. And now under 2 minutes as Gabe Pruitt puts up the left fist for this next half-court set. Blakely gives it up to Mason. And Mason off the screen retreats a bit. Now gives it up Blakely. Blakely can't pass it. Now we'll try to work it around. Blakely still with a bounce at his disposal, 4 to shoot. Blakely spins towards the baseline. Gilder will put it up, and it's good at the buzzer. Beats the shot clock, and Trey Gilder will make it 85-72. Gilder with 18 points. Wise on the bounce, gets all the way in the lane, kicks it out. Thomas, 3, and it's too strong. Rebound, same players go after it, and they'll say off the Skyforce. Gilder and Benson unable to gather it in. And Adrian Thomas, the 6'7 forward out of Miami, has been good numerous times. 4 of 7 from behind the arc, but not that time, but new juice for the jam. Wise slips and gets the ball back with his rump on the floor. That's not a violation. He was already down when he got the ball. Now Byers loses his balance, and they're going to call a foul on Sioux Falls. And that is on Blakely. Going to call him on the block. And Blakely picks up his second. Byers back to the line with 1:05. So Byers, a chance to continue his free throw string, which stands at 7. We're nowhere near Blake Ahern territory, but we'll see if Byers can continue the parade. He's got 20 points on the night. And the first free throw, release from the right hand, is good. That's 8 in a row. 86-72. And it's the separation that Bakersfield looking for. They've been kind of toggling between 15 and 13 points between the two teams. Now it works from 11 to 13 points. Now it's 15 again, 87-72. 1 minute left in this third quarter. Pruitt shifts left side, three for Mason. Boom! For Anthony Mason Jr. He's got 9 points off the feed from Gabe Pruitt. 50 seconds left in the third quarter, and it's a 12-point game. Wise gets in the lane, and he is going to be obstructed by Benson, and Cook has the rebound. They're going to call a foul on Mason on the rake. 87-75, and more free throws coming for the Jam. And for Mason, we'll pick up his fourth. So two players now for the Skyforce with four personal fouls. Adam Cook, 82% free throw shooter for the season, 2 of 2 so far tonight, swishes the first. Cook with 7 points. He averages about 6.6 a game, so has just surpassed his average. 88-75. Second toss. Yes. 89-75. 40 seconds left, third quarter. Pruitt works left side. Gives to Blakely at the top. Blakely in the lane, shoots it over Cook, and it hits the rim. Had enough momentum to get over the 10 and through. They're going to call a delay a game against the Skyforce. 89-77. But Blakely drives it in the lane and scores. And he's got 20 points. 89-77. As Wise is going to take some time off the clock here at the end of the third quarter. Just over 6 seconds between the timepieces. Wise into the double team, retreats. Now will attack. Now triple team. And Cook has it escape his hands. Ball stripped. And the shot clock will go off. But the Skyforce come the other way. 3 seconds left in the quarter. And the shot goes by Trey Gilder on a drive. And he'll go to the line to push the Skyforce to a possible 9-point deficit here at the end of quarter number three. And the fourth personal will be whistled on Vanderbeeken. Boy, Trey Gilder rushing to the right baseline. Pushed the shot off the glass. Kicked off the rim and then through the twine. Gilder the free throw. Yes. And now another steal. Blakely puts it up at the buzzer. It was just short. But Blakely with the steal and the possibility of further dampening the Bakersfield spirits, which no doubt have to be low. They led by 23 during that third quarter, but they take it to the fourth, leading by 9, 89-80. Back in 2 minutes with the fourth quarter on the NBA Development League Radio Network. Skyforce outscore the Bakersfield Jam 30-19 in quarter number three. Falls to within 9 points, 89-80. Bakersfield not shooting as well. They're down to 55% for the game. Skyforce picking it up. They're 46% for the contest. Pruitt has it for the Skyforce as they begin the fourth quarter with possession. Benson nearly lost the handle. Does have a bounce. Will take it. Gives it up to Pruitt. He will jump it from the left side. It's too strong. Rebound. Kicks out to center court. Keith Benson will track it down. New juice for the Skyforce as they play it with 11:35 left in the contest. Blakely, right block. Double team. Gets it up to Gilder. Gilder is triple teamed. Ball flies in the air. It's loose. Vanderbeeken comes up with it. He and Benson going at it, and Vanderbeeken able to capture the ball. Wise is going to take it into the lane, and it's too strong. Rebound to Sioux Falls. They come the other way. Pruitt, Blakely, right side, gives it up Benson. He will drive, and he will miss the shot off the front iron, looking for a call, didn't get it. Juan Patillo on the defense for the Bakersfield Jam, preventing Benson from getting two more. 89-80. Still, after we played a minute, 2 seconds of this fourth quarter. Wise pitches left side to Thomas. And the 6'7 forward from Miami will give it back to Wise at the top. Wise with the lefty jumper is good. With two on the shot clock, jumps inside the arc, gets his second bucket of the game. And it's 91-80. Ryan Hamilton is checked back on. He whistles a pass inside Benson. Up, no good, but two more at the line for Benson coming. Vanderbeeken will pick up number five.
Jimmy Vanderbeeken.
10:34 left in the fourth quarter. And Benson has been alternating makes and misses at the line. And a chance to work it back down to single digits. Cannot on the first. So Benson remains at 10 points, and the lead is still 11 for the Jam, 91-80. Rinaldo Major will check on. Adrian Thomas will sit, and Vanderbeeken will also sit. And checking back on, Derek Byers for the Jam. And the second free throw, no good for Benson. Rebound, Bakersfield. An empty trip for Sioux Falls, 91-80. Wise looks to the left, shifts it back to the right, Patillo. Patillo free throw line jumper is good. Thought that one was going to drift to the left, but it did. A course correction in midair, and Patillo makes it 93-80. First 4 points of the fourth quarter come in Bakersfield's hands. Blakely trying to clear some space, gets in the lane, tough shot, and it just drops off the rim. No good, but Blakely to the line for a pair.
Second team.
10:03 left, fourth quarter. Blakely to the line.
Marcus Blakely in the line, shooting two.
And Blakely with number one rattles in and out. Skyforce will replace Keith Benson in the lineup with Yemi Agunye. Gilder, Pruitt, Hamilton, and Blakely still on. Blakely at the line. Blakely got the second. 93-81, it's a 12-point Bakersfield lead with 10 to go. Wise is kind of crab-walking his way across the line, gives it up to Patillo. Patillo drives, Adam Cook will lay it up and in. Nice look from Patillo, drew the defense, and another assisted basket for the Jam. Cook with 10 points. Hamilton, he will jump it for three, and that's a line driver. It's too strong. Now Byers is going to run it the other way. Byers gives it up to Wise, who will give it up to Patillo, who will jam it through and pose. 97-81, as the Jam have put together an 8-point, 8-1 run to start this fourth quarter. 9:30 to go, fourth quarter. Let's pause 10 seconds for stations to identify themselves on the NBA Development League Radio Network. Timeout on the court with the Jam leading by 16, 97-81. Back in 2 minutes on the D-League Radio Network.
Minnesota Timberwolves autographed basketball. Two courtside tickets to the next Skyforce home game, March
Skyforce basketball. They trail it by 16. Ball still in the way. Ronaldo Major jumps the pass. And Major will take it front court in the lane, kicks it out. And here's a three, and it's rejected out of bounds by Brian Hamilton. Hamilton came flying in to prevent an attempt by Derek Byers. Still, Bakersfield ball, and they have a 16-point lead. Well, during that third quarter, Skyforce were able to pick it up with 13 of 23 from the floor, and the Jam only 4 of 14 in that third quarter. So that was the reason for the Skyforce able to work a 23-point deficit down to 9. But the Jam have put together a nice little run to start this fourth quarter. Patillo in the lane, dotted line, jumps it up, scores. Took off from the dotted line, got it all the way to the jar and put it in. And that's 6 for Patillo in the quarter, and he's got 17, 99 to 81. Here's a kick to Gilder. Malcolm Lee gives it up, and Gilder gets in the lane. He is mugged, and he'll go to the line. Gilder with a good night going so far. He's got 21 points. And at the free throw line so far, he is 5 of 6 from the stripe. And Gilder has been leading the Skyforce in scoring the last 5 games. Oh, and misses the first free throw. He's leading so far tonight. But he's got Blakely right hot on his heels with 20 points. Blakely off the floor right now. Anthony Mason Jr. will check back on. Yemi Agunye will check out. Malcolm Lee's back on the floor for the Skyforce as well. Nope, Blakely is on the floor. My apologies. Second toss off the back rim. Blakely the rebound. Blakely trying to put it back up, and he is rejected by Patillo. And the rebound to Wise. Wise will take it in the lane, take it all the way in. Ball is loose. Blakely has it. He'll give it up to Lee, and Lee with a spin. He will take it to the glass. Missed the layup. Put back dunk by Blakely. It does not count. There will be a foul on the Bakersfield Jam in the form of Juan Patillo. And Patillo will pick up his second. Malcolm Lee at the line. He has had a very productive night for the Skyforce. First toss is good. Since he's been with the Skyforce, Malcolm Lee has hit all of his free throws, and that is his fourth attempt. And can get into double figures if he can hit a second attempt. Malcolm Lee with 7 assists so far. Now with 10 points, he could get a double-double. But he would rather take the win, 99-83, as the Bakersfield Jam lead it by 16. And a quick trigger for Patillo. Nope, he'll decide to send it up top. Jeremy Wise, he'll work a little clock. Wise will get it back to Patillo on the left. Byers back to Patillo, who's cutting to the basket, and it's tipped away by Hamilton, 6 to shoot. And again tipped away by Hamilton. Patillo still with the ball. They get it down low. Major turnaround jumper, beats the shot clock, misses off the back iron. Back up by Byers, and he'll go to the line, and the reach by Brian Hamilton. That is number 2 on Hamilton. Boy, the Skyforce did all he could ask for, but then Bakersfield able to get second opportunities. 8:02 left in the fourth quarter. And Byers at the line. Good on the first. Byers with 23, including a string of 10 in a row at the stripe. Wise is out, and Osiris Eldridge will check on. Byers back to the stripe. Has a sleeve on his right elbow, starting at the bicep, ending at the wrist. Second free throw is good. 24 for Derek Byers out of Vanderbilt. 101-83. And the Skyforce need to pick it up to be able to pull this one out. They trail by 18 at the 7:50 mark. Gilder's going to drive. He'll get contact, short on the jumper, but he'll go to the line for 2. And Gilder working his way back to the stripe. Missed a pair earlier. And drew the foul on Adam Cook. And that's number 2 on Cook. Jam now in the penalty for the balance of the quarter. And Gilder, the first, is no good. So Gilder stuck on 21 points, and the Skyforce trail by 18. Second toss. That one is good. 101-84 at the 7:46 mark of the fourth quarter. Skyforce put together a little trap in backcourt, and then they'll increase the pressure in front court. But now the Osiris Eldridge. Ooh, it gives up. Oh, and it caroms off of Brian Hamilton out of bounds. It hit Byers. Brian Hamilton tapped it off Byers, then it kicked off Hamilton, and then out of bounds. 7:33 left in the fourth quarter. 10 to shoot in this half-court set as Major will inbound it from the hash. They get it in, and Patillo with 9. Patillo crosses over, jumps it from the free throw line. No good. Rebound Blakely, able to work it down low for the board. To the front court comes Hamilton. Hamilton kicks to Gilder, left side. Back up top, Lee, who will settle it, and he'll finger out the next play. Lee is going to take it in the jar. Oh, I guess that's what the play is. He'll take it all the way in. Missed the jumper, and we've got an offensive foul. Byers ended up on the deck, and Malcolm Lee will be whistled for the charge. And that is his second. 7:11 left. Fourth quarter. Clock resumes as Eldridge, trapped at the timeline, he gives it up to Byers on the left. Byers, two defenders will come at him, and now Patillo over to Major, right side. Back up top, Patillo. Patillo with a couple of bounces. It's stripped away. Here comes Brian Hamilton. In it goes with authority. And Brian Hamilton with a strip and the slam. 101-86. 6:44 to go in this one. Eldridge will take it to the timeline. Here comes Mason to oppose. And the Skyforce trying to jump the passing lanes. There's a jumper that's no good from three for Byers. Skyforce, Blakely the rebound. Here comes Lee, gives it up to Mason. Mason will drive in the paint, get it up and scores. Finger roll for Anthony Mason Jr. He's got 11 points, and that prompts a call for time for the Bakersfield Jam. Will Voigt will talk it over with his mate John Bryant and the rest of his brain trust, and the run for the Skyforce makes it a 101-88 contest. 5-point Skyforce run with 6:21 left in the fourth quarter. Back in 2 minutes on the D-League Radio Network. Bakersfield ball, and they lead by 13. Osiris Eldridge puts on the brakes, and two defenders swarm him, and they get it away to Patillo. Patillo reverse layup is good. That time Bakersfield trying to efficiently not succumb to the pressure, and they get it in the form of Juan Patillo. Patillo's got 19 points, 103-88. Lee looks it over left side. Off the screen from Gilder. Lee into the lane, kicks to Mason. Three, right side, swish! Anthony Mason Jr., second three-pointer of the half, and it's 14 points for Mason, 103-91. 5:41 to go. 12-point game. Eldridge gives it up to Patillo. Patillo well out on the left, and now will take it from 17 feet. Jumps too strong. Rebound Lee. And the Skyforce can get it down to 10 points with a make here. Gilder in the lane. Spins around his man. Puts it up and in. Gilder with 24 points. 103-93. Eldridge with a low dribble, shadowed by Hamilton, gives it up to Major. Major runs over his man, blocking foul. Trey Gilder can't believe it. And that's five on Trey. Gilder went skidding on his rump roast. And Major was able to draw the contact. 5:06 left fourth quarter. Gilder's going to stay on. But he's got five personal fouls. Mo McCone is going to ride that horse for as long as it lasts. Major gets it in off the trigger. He was not on the act of shooting. Skyforce not within the bonus. Eldridge with a three. Left side, it's no good. Rebound kicks to Byers. And the Bakersfield Jam have new time. Jeremy Wise with a left-handed dribble in close proximity to the midcourt stripe, and is being hounded there by Anthony Mason Jr., and Mason will give him a little shove, and that's number five on Mason. Still a 10-point game, 103-93. And that is team foul number three on Sioux Falls. And Mason and Gilder will stay on with the foul trouble. 4:42 left. They get it in. And Eldridge looks it over with 10 to shoot. Backs it out. Now we'll get it out. Lee has it kicked out of his hands, and then the ball caroms back to Eldridge, then to Patillo through the cylinder authoritatively for Juan Patillo. He's got 21. On the other end, Gilder reels in the pass near the baseline, a little off balance, and he has to get the bounce and take it back out. 4:17 left. Here's a three for Malcolm Lee. Too strong. Rebound. All blue underneath. As the Bakersfield Jam reel in the rebound. 105-93. 4:07 left. And the ball is tipped. Stolen by the Skyforce. Malcolm Lee with a couple of moves. Loses the handle. Eldridge against Mason. He's got his wingman. No, it's Eldridge. He'll take it. Strong to the goal. And Eldridge with five. Make it 7 points off the bench. And it's 107-93, 3:53 left in this fourth quarter. We will take a two-minute break and return with more of this fourth quarter on the NBA Development League Radio Network. 107-93, the Bakersfield Jam lead it. 14 points the spread at the 3:40 mark of the fourth quarter. Game is tight in Texas as the Austin Toros lead the Legends 85-84 in their contest, while the Canton Charge had defeated Iowa tonight 122-107. So far in this one, the Jam able to get big production off the bench from Juan Patillo with 21 points and Derek Byers with 24 to help their effort tonight, as the Jam 3 minutes and 40 seconds away from putting up a win against the Skyforce on enemy floor. Trey Gilder has 24 points and 11 rebounds to lead the Skyforce. Marcus Blakely with 21 points and 10 rebounds. A couple of double-doubles. Malcolm Lee in his night on assignment from the Minnesota Timberwolves. 10 points, 3 steals, 8 assists, 5 turnovers. Derek Byers, not only does he have 24 points, he also has 15 rebounds and 4 assists. Patillo is going to take it to the midcourt stripe, gives it up to Eldridge. Eldridge with another post-station slam! Osiris Eldridge has 9, and it's 109-93 with 3:29 left in the fourth quarter. Skyforce trying to gamble at every opportunity, trying to get the ball back and work it down, unable to do so. And this game was 103-93 not too long ago, but the last 6 points on the board to the Bakersfield Jam, and it puts them in prime position to pick up their 19th win of the season. Skyforce called timeout, a brief variety, and I think most of that will be used by Coach Mo McCone to voice his displeasure mainly with the officials. And he is still taking them to task. Skyforce basketball after the Osiris Eldridge fireworks at the 10. Lee has it, right wing. And we'll get it to Gilder on the baseline. Gilder works his way in the lane, jumps it in the lane off the glass. No good, but we'll go to the line for a pair. So Gilder can continue his scoring prowess tonight. Big quarter for Gilder was the third quarter. Put up 10 points in that frame. And Gilder for the Skyforce has been the main scoring threat since a February 10th contest against Idaho. Gilder gets the first free throw. He led the team with 23 points that night. Second free throw, dances, doesn't fall inside the cylinder. Out it comes. And so one of two for Gilder, 109-94. The ball caroms to Ronaldo Major in the corner. 14 to shoot, getting down to 3 minutes left in this one. Major retreating towards the midcourt stripe. Now will attack on Lee. Gets around him, gets it to the baseline, kicks to Patillo, and he shoots it from the baseline and scores. A 15-footer for Juan Patillo. And he has 23 points. And it's 111-94, 2:42 left. Into the lane, contact as Brian Hamilton works his way to the rim. He'll go to the line for a pair. Now, I was mentioning Gilder. 23 points against Idaho to lead the team, 24 against Canton, 30 against Tulsa, 27 against Tulsa, and then 20 against Dakota. Last five games, Gilder has been the leading scorer. First toss for Hamilton, no good. Hamilton with 4 points on the night. And the second toss, Hamilton, that one's good. 111-95 and 2:40 left. Gambling for the steal is Hamilton, doesn't get it. Eldridge takes it across the court, and he drops the ball. Falls down, and the Skyforce come the other way. Here comes the lob, and it's too far up in the air for Lee. He just ends up with just rim and no ball. 111-95 it remains, and Hamilton gives Major a little shove. And Hamilton will pick up his third personal foul. Not on the penalty yet. And Wise gets the ball in. Ellen Byers had a toe on the line. So Byers with a violation before he can get the ball in bounds. So to 2:20 left, and it's 111-95. And inbound, here comes Hamilton. Gets it from the side. He will slap it. Now open up his palm and say, hey, where are we got? Okay, Lee will pick up the ball. Lee will step back, jump it up, and it's in and out. Rebound Major. Major tries to clear some space with the elbow. Does so and gets it off to Wise. To Eldridge. And Eldridge looks to attack, fades back. Jumper, it's short by Byers, and Lee pulls up with the rebound. Knocked away by Byers, and he comes away with a loop with loose ball. And Byers still with the pumpkin. Under 2 minutes left. Byers still with it, and he is fouled by Lee. And Byers, no, they'll say offensive foul on Byers. Byers with the push. Lee kind of like a gnat in the ear. Byers not appreciative. 111-95, Gilder's going to sit for the final 151. And in to replace him is Agunye. And Anthony Mason Jr. jumps it in the lane and hits. Mason with 16, 111-97. Other way go the Jam. Final minute 40 in this contest. Skyforce still opposing the passing lanes. They get it inside. Byers turns around. He is rudely met by Brian Hamilton. That's number four. Byers to the line. And Byers with 24, leading scorer honors by just one over Juan Patillo. And Byers to the line where he has gotten all of his points in the second half. And he swishes this one. Ever since he hit a three back in the second quarter, he has scored all of his points from the free throw line. And Byers working on quite a string. Hits again. Byers hitting 12 in a row. 113-97 with a minute and a half left. Mason will take it. He will jump it from 20. Good. Nice stroke for Anthony Mason Jr. 113-99, but the lead is 14 with 120 to go. Wise loops it to the front court. Major. Major will work some time off the clock. Eldridge as they weave it around near the midcourt stripe. Skyforce advance with a minute 8 left. 8 to shoot. Ball goes out of bounds. They'll say still Bakersfield ball with 6 to shoot. Blakely and Hamilton converging on Eldridge. Byers will get it in near the midcourt stripe and does to Major. Major trying to work it. And will fire up a desperation. He with four to shoot, and it's Agunye on the rebound. Other way come the Skyforce. Lee, here's a three for Mason. He doesn't have the stroke there. And the rebound weak side comes to Eldridge. 48 seconds left. Eldridge will take it front court, hounded by Lee, and hounded. Now he gets it away to Major. Eldridge will kind of casually walk off the side, and Major is going to be pushed by Anthony Mason Jr., and that will signal the end of the night for Anthony Mason Jr. He will be removed from play with 16 points. And the lion's share of that coming in this fourth quarter. And so Mason out of the game with 16 points. And Major at the line. Shooting the first of two is no good. 114-99. Still a 15-point game. Oh, he did hit the first one. Sorry about that. 115-99. Now it's a 16-point game. 36 seconds and ticking. As Hamilton works to the free throw line, gets his way in, bulls his way to the hoop, and will pick up some contact with 28.9. Hamilton to the stripe. to the stripe comes Hamilton, and his toss is in and out. 115-99 the score, and Hamilton the second, the release, and it clings to the rim, drops in. 115-100. And Eldridge hounded, but does get it across the midcourt stripe. We'll take some time off the clock. Lee gets, squirts the ball loose, and Lee and Blakely will run. Lee will lay it up and in with 15 seconds left. And that will probably be the end of scoring on the night. Lee with 12 points. 115-102. And Major will have Gilder close, but Gilder will just kind of playfully pat at the ball. Actually, he's knocked out of bounds by Blakely with 4.7 left. And they're done screwing around. This is over. 115-102 as the final has been reached here at the Sioux Falls Arena. The Bakersfield Jam, led by 9 at the end of quarter number 3, but able to survive the fourth quarter, extend their lead back up to 18 points during that final frame. And the Jam able to get win number 19 on the season against 16 losses, and the Skyforce dropped to 9-26.